Good afternoon, gentlemen and ladies also. Thank you for the opportunity, dear AQ team. I represent Sterling and Wilson, who is known for utility scale projects on a larger picture of solar, having around more than a gigawatt of portfolio in the utility scale. But still, on the rooftop segment, we are putting our small steps, which has just started 2 years back, a year back, and in the second year of operations. The challenges, I mean, I would like to take up some of the issues on the challenges of EPC, because I have to talk on EPC. O&M, I think our friend has given a very fantastic picture of O&M and optimizing the O&M and the cost. How many of you are pure EPC people? 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, I think very less people share my concerns, because I think you may be undergoing. Rest others, I think, maybe in the manufacturing or the investment segment, looking EPC as the people who are making money out of their business. Really, I think we are undergoing a lot of challenges. EPC as such is a very, very challenging activity, which starts from the scale of operation. When we say EPC, EPC has a very big market in the solar segment, given that particularly in the rooftop segment, given that the target of the country and all, I mean, all of us know about that. I don't want to repeat about our 40 megawatt thinking, and then ultimately Marcom or Solar Edge predicting that I think we may end up in around 10 to 12 gigawatt of installation at the end. Gigawatt of installation by 2022. That's the market. So we have a huge market in front of us as a EPC operator. But where is it seen and how is it done? That's the question. That is where we are every day trying to address those issues. The challenge starts from the business model itself, whether the EPC is coming to you through an IPP model or a CAPEX model, an OPEX or a CAPEX model. The moment the project is defined as an OPEX model, it will have its own dimensions. And the moment it is defined as a CAPEX model owner investing it, that has a different dimension altogether, right from the composition of the project and the completion of the project and delivering the end results. So that is the first challenge, which starts from the business model. Then comes the regulatory challenges, where we have to undergo a lot of regulatory understanding first and then compliance next. So each state, or we being operating across India, I think we come across almost different rules, regulations, easiness, difficulty levels, all the things we face. There are certain states which are very easy, certain states which is very difficult to crack. So that is another challenge where we have to face the regulatory. That regulatory, right from the capacity identification and the capacity finalization for that, and the evacuation permissions, and finally closing the projects with all the permits in hand to the end customer, or whether he is an investor or whether it's a CAPEX. Then comes the design challenges. Rooftop is very easy to say. A roof is there and people have to put some panels over that. Rooftop challenges are the design challenges starts from, again, scale of the project. If it is a residential, the challenges are different. If it is a commercial building, the challenges are different. And for the industrial buildings, it's again different. Right from the roof details, the stability, the type of roof and the type of orientation it has, the inclination or the azimuth, which is required to optimize the power generation and also the optimize the costing. So that is on the throws a big picture on how you select the structures and end up in giving a very good capacity, because the capacity identification, the normally when we go to market, I think the first thing which we say is that your competitor has given 600 kilowatt design where you are coming up with 500. That means, have you optimized your capacity when you offer? So the capacity optimization, and then if it is again, if it is a developer project, then the generation optimization, because developer will be looking at how maximum within the given roof which you can develop and which you can generate and give it. So that is the second part. And the third thing and the most important thing will be the cost challenges, because you have to deliver a project within certain cost which you have agreed, or you have to be competitive. I mean, if it is in the bidding stage, to be very competitive, what are all the components which you consider, and what level of components, what level of quality, what level of scale which you can buy and then deliver. That is the cost challenge. And in case if there is a consultant or if any other media involved in between, then the specifications, then the compliance, then the inspections. There are several other factors which will add on to the design cost and then give you a cost challenge in the during the design. Then comes the evacuation point. Where are you evacuating? How far it is? What kind of cable? What is the voltage drop you are trying to maintain? What is the voltage drop required to be maintained as per norms? Or what else you can compromise over there? How do you take the cables? The associated parts like trenches or the cable trays, which all add to more complication as well as the cost. But the from the beginning, you have a challenge to optimize both of them. So that is another this thing. And the last point in the evacuation is again the customer infrastructure support, which will to get the evacuation done, the DG synchronization in case they have a DG, and the capacity matching of the DG, whether your rooftop solar capacity versus the existing DG capacity, will they really match for a successful synchronization, or whether you have to make some avoidance. And the harmonics and power factor, I mean, these are other electrical factors which you have to, because mostly when the project is conceived or when it starts, these things will not come into discussion also in many cases. Only when it is getting commissioned and the handing over, I think when he say the handing over documentation, then all these things starts coming, because most of the maintenance team by that time would have become most intelligent people of the customer side, and then start giving you all the jitters in the commissioning part. So that is another challenge. Then comes the procurement challenges. When you operate when you are operating a plant or a system, I mean, what big scale you are. One advantage which Sterling Wilson has or perceived to be having is the scale of operations. I mean, we buy a lot of materials, being our MEP business as well as the utility solar business, then we have some advantage of the vendor base as well as the capacity of buying. But for most of the other EPC operators, I think that may not be the case, because we have to buy on case-to-case basis, where the buying of small length cables or the delivering it and the transportation of the small lengths or small capacity, this thing will definitely put a pressure on your transportation and the freight costs, as well as the availability and the timely availability more than anything. So these are some of the challenges on the supply chain. But looking at the larger picture, when we have this thing scale to deliver, then a kind of 10 gigawatt, whether we have in our country, I mean, the capacity to deliver such kind of equipments in a short time, or in 3 years or 3.5 years, what we are looking at. So that is the manufacturing base or the supply chain challenge also will start appearing. Construction, I don't think I need to elaborate, because my time is also coming up. The infrastructure, it starts from access to the roof. I mean, we call it a rooftop. The moment the installation team visits site, the first trouble will be to access the roof. How to access the roof safely and also along with all the materials. So that is another challenge. And availability of resources, I think the resource crunch is going to kill all of us, because the trained resources who can safely and quality delivery of the project at the end of the day is going to be a dearth if we consider 10 gigawatt as in next 3 years, which the industry has to deliver. And the permissions I discussed. Then, of course, O&M is another this thing which he has already covered. So, getting into these challenges, the industry is looking lucrative, industry is having a lot of job in hand. The most important thing an EPC operator has to develop, which I see right now, is the IPP projects are coming up in large scale under the government segment, where that is where the capacity is going to be built. Railways have come up with 100 megawatt, and SECI is coming out with 500 and 1 gigawatt. Where developers are there, we saw in the first session, there are a lot of developers who are ready to invest and then put money. But how do you, as an EPC operator, how do you develop an ecosystem for this large scale? It is like a carpet bombing. I think when you say 100 megawatt of railway platforms, I mean, across all the railway stations will come to accumulate that. But how do you do that in a time frame where you deliver and then people and the quality, design? So this is the ecosystem which the industry or the developers are looking, which is a challenge. I think Sterling and Wilson, at our end, we are working out some strategies to address this issue so that we can feed IPP operators with a commendable resource and ecosystem where they can depend on us to get such deliveries. With this, I thank you once again for your patience hearing.